Long ago, centuries after Equestria was found, the ponies had witnessed a miracle. A meteor shower flown across the night sky, and six colorful strands of light emerged and crashed onto the land. Coincidentally, it was the exact moment that the first daughter of King Solaris and Queen Stella, Princess Celestia, was born. Hearing about the crashing, Solaris sent forth his guards to investigate and report of him as their findings. Soon after, they returned with the source of the lights. Laid before him were six gems. They weren't ordinary gems, for they had such a spectrum of colors, much like a rainbow, and they glowed brightly. Unsure of the power of these gems, Solaris seeked the help of Star's World the Bearded, re-owned wizard and the royal family's closest friend. When Star's World studied the gems and its magical aura, he told Solaris that the gems came from a legend came true and that they are owned to destroy all evil, and when united together, they bring harmony and peace to the land. The legend he mentioned foretold that the lights will fall to the sky to bring forth warriors who would bear the aura of the gems and the will to control its abilities. As it was unclear why the gems are connected to ponykind, he theorized that the gems not only regenerate strange magic, but also points to the bearer's destiny. Throughout Star Swirl's vision, he sees that the only ponies that were born under the lights is the newborn princess, Celestia later on, a second daughter, Luna, would join her by the gems' bond. He also predicted that once the meteor showers come back and the lights emerge again, the princesses will be forever disconnected from the gems, and its magic will be transferred to the next generation of bearers. Trusting the friend's vision, Solaris decided to have the gems re-signed and guarded safely at the Canterlot Castle Tower until Celestia and Luna will be given to them when they're older. The future Star Swirl predicted has certainly came true as the lights came back and found six new bearers to wield the powers of gems, now called the Elements of Harmony. Even though Princess Celestia and Luna, the official rulers of Equestria, no longer hold the elements' power, it didn't mean that they won't abandon them and the bearers. They've become close friends to them and their families while aiding them in their battles. And as promised, not only did the bearers bring harmony to Equestria and defeated many darkness imaginable, but they also brought inspiration to the ponies and became adorned to them. And also, as promised, after the first generation of bearers has passed, the lights came back and bring forth the birth of new bearers to wield the elements. Then again, and again, the cycle kept going for 1,000 years. It wasn't until the recent generation of bearers has come under the lights once more that Equestria was struck with tragedy. On the day after the lights, one of the newborn foals born that night has been mysteriously disappeared. The kingdom has searched for months, but was left with no results. It was then the hope of finding the missing child began to fade from the ponies, who had become despaired. Princess Celestia and Luna, as they were disconnected from the elements years before, promised to do whatever they can do to find the missing bearer and bring harmony back again. This event is known later on in history to have broken the chain of harmony and brought forth, possibly, a new era of darkness for all of Equestria. Cursor from page 283, paragraph 6. Many historians and scientists...
Spike, you don't have to read the footnotes. I've read that part already.
Oops. Sorry, Twi. But if you already read this issue of History of Equestria and Beyond, then why did you have me reading this to you?
Well, as much as I think the issue is fine as its own, there are certain areas in the book that don't show enough evidence to the disappearance. I want to talk to Princess Celestia about it when we get to the castle.
Like what?
Give me that. Okay, look here on this page. You notice something odd about what it says about Starswell's theory about the elements? It goes into full detail on why the elements choose a bearer when it's born, or even how it works. And the paragraph about the search of the missing bearers is a little vague, and the author had missed out a lot of good points of the investigation. He didn't even mention that the missing bearer was meant for the element of kindness.
Only you can criticize literal interpretations. I mean, it could be possible that this book is a bit outdated. Like, remember 5 years ago when you had to claim your element with the other bearers? The author wouldn't know which element belongs to the missing bearer if you didn't claim it. Plus, maybe any other books have the information that this doesn't have.
I know, but this is the only one I can find that is remotely close to the information I have, while having two topics at the same time. That's why I need to talk to Princess Celestia.
Certainly hasn't changed the last time we were here. You think with the lack of harmony around, they would try to play fair? Twilight?
Don't worry about it, Spike. We'll bring harmony back some way. I know it. Oh, yeah. That felt good. Home sweet home. Thank you, guards. You deserve the rest of the day off.
Boy, it's been so long since we've been here. I was starting to miss this castle.
Yeah, I missed it too.
Welcome home, Princess Twilight.
Oh, please, you don't need to bow. It's good to see you, Captain.
I take the compromise with the Griffins went well?
More than well, Captain. It may have taken them a lot of convincing, but I say it's enough to have them on our side.
Excellent, Princess. I'll go report your return to the princesses.
Wait, Captain? I need to speak with Princess Celestia personally. Is she in the throne room?
No, I don't think so. With Princess Luna raising the moon soon, she has the night off. Do you want me to find her for you?
No, thanks. I can do that. Spike! Help the Captain with the luggage to our room!
Like she said, it was a long trip.
Princess Celestia.
Good evening.
Fair still inside, Your Highness. No pony has disturbed this area.
Very good. You may rest for now.
Yes, Princess.
Princess Celestia!
Twilight!
I missed you so much, Princess.
And I missed you too. I trust the alliance with the Griffins gone well?
You'll be expecting a treaty signed by Griffinstone very soon.
I'm very glad to hear that. And I'm also glad we have the opportunity to have more resources to help protect Equestria. Shouldn't you be resting? The trip must have been long.
It was, Princess. But there is something I need to ask you about.
About what?
About what happened 20 years ago, and the elements of harmony. You see, I read the book you gave me, and I feel like something was missing about the subject and the connection with the elements. Since you and Princess Luna were the first bearers, I was hoping if you know why or how do they work that way, and how does it affect Equestria?
I see. I think it is fair that I tell you this. After all, the bearer of magic does need to know about their power and mysteries. Come sit with me.
Okay.
Twilight, do you remember the other bearers you met 5 years ago?
From the coronation?
Yes.
I think I do remember one or two of them.
And do you remember the elements they ordained?
I remember that pink, bouncy pony from Ponyville, lose the element of laughter. Which, now that I think about it, it does seem to suit her pretty-
Because? Why do you think it suited her?
Well, she looks silly.
Is she?
Yes! I mean, the first time I met her at the coronation, she gave me cupcakes and sang this quick, perky Best Friend Forever song that everybody saw, and they-
Did every pony enjoy her song?
Well, yeah, from what I remembered. I'm sorry, what does this have to do with the elements?
That's the reason why she is the element of laughter.
I thought I already established that earlier.
I know, but that is almost exactly the point. Pinkie Pie was given her element because of her virtues. The fact I know is because Luna used to own that element. We and all past bearers share the same element because they reflect on our spirits and virtues. Laughter can be shown not only to reflect one's sense of humor, but rather as a sign of sharing love. A love that infects other ponies to do the same for others. A way to show them that you can have hope and lightheartedness at the bleakest of times.
So, the elements are connected to the bearers because of the specific pony?
Exactly how did you get your cutie mark?
Because I freaked out on my entrance exam?
It's because you possess an incredible amount of magic. The element of magic signifies the leader of the group, but needs one with the most power to signal the elements to use its powers for good. You were capable to handle it back then when you were a unicorn, but you proving your worth and earning your title shows how you were truly born to this element. All of these elements bring out the best in all creatures. They are connected to who they are, what they stand for, and what brings out the good inside of them, and inspires us in so many ways. I have been friends with past bearers, and every single time I see them, they reflected truly to their element. That is how I remembered them, and how the rest of Equestria remembers them. They had loved them so much that it pains them to see one of them has passed on. Each element is important to both the bearers and Equestria. Without them, we would lose hope and all the things that are good in our lives, which is why the disappearance is so relevant to this day.
So it's true. Did they stop looking for him or her?
Not really. We only kept it to keep a close eye for anything suspicious. Why we can't go any further with it was because there weren't any clues or evidence that could have helped us.
What about the parents?
They didn't witness the disappearance when it happened, and I'm afraid that they were too distraught to help us. The last time I've heard of them, the mother died from a broken heart, and the father had moved away, taking his son with him.
Princess? What would happen if the missing bearer doesn't claim the element of kindness? Would there be another bearer after him or her?
Twilight, I don't know. And I don't know if there is a possibility. You have seen how much this land has suffered from a lack of harmony. Countries growing distant, ponies filled with hatred and disregarding their own kind, and all things evil still lurking around, waiting to attack. For all we know, we could stay this way forever.
So, we're the last generation of bearers? And there's nothing we can do about it?
Only waiting for a miracle. I'm sorry if I frightened you with this, but you needed to know this.
It's okay, Princess. I'm just glad you're honest with me.
Well, it was one of my elements. Dinner would be done soon. Care to walk with me to fetch Luna?
Of course. Just curious, what was it like having the elements for the first time?
Kind of unexpected, to be honest. When Star Swirl showed them to us at Luna's 8th birthday, we all thought it was a joke.
Thank you. Good morning, Gypsum.
Morning, General.
Any trouble at all?
Nothing to report. The night went well as usual.
Is she awake?
She should be. She knows when to be on time.
You may be excused.
Yes, General.
Nameless, it's time to go! Come on, we haven't got all day.
Yes, sir.
You will start where you left off at the castle foyer.
But you threw out the water I had before.
Then you go fetch more at the colony, and then you can start the stairs all over again.
Yes, sir.
Your Highness. Your daughter is now doing today's work.
Good. Where is she now?
She's heading toward the colony to fetch water. She'll be washing the foyer.
How long will it take her?
A few hours. We'll give her more tasks as soon as she's done.
Excellent. You may leave now. Crystal ball, show me Nameless.
It's Nameless.
What is she doing here?
She must be here for our water.
Whatever she's doing, she better be out of here soon.
Stay calm, Nameless. The well is just on the other side of the cave. All I need to do is go grab some water and go back to the castle without any incidents. Unless they come back again. No! Focus! You can do this.
Good morning, Your Highness. Strange to see you out here again.
I'm just here to get some water for my duties in the castle. I'm going to be out of here as soon as possible.
No trouble at all. Proceed.
Thank you.
It's probably good that you won't be able to stay for long. Can't have that mistake again, won't we?
Of course not, Magna. I would never do that.
Well, I'm sure everyone here will be glad of that.
Big Magma, what is she doing here?
It's nothing. She's just getting some water. She'll be out of here after that.
Oh, that's good. I was wondering how long I'd have to look at her.
Psst, watch this.
Oh, my.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Princess. I didn't mean that.
What's the matter? Weak in the knees as usual?
Better leave her alone. We're only keeping her here longer. You three go back to patrol. I'll take care of her.
Very well. Here's your bucket, Princess.
Please don't call me that. It makes me uncomfortable.
We'll see you later.
Why does it make you feel uncomfortable?
What?
Why can't he call you Princess? After all, you are the Princess of the Changelings, daughter of the Queen.
Well, if I'm a princess, then why aren't you a prince?
We Changelings don't get to decide our fate or birth for that matter. It's kind of funny. Out of all of us in the kingdom, any one of us could be fit to be royalty. And yet, it had to be you. Do you know why I think you don't deserve to be a princess?
Because I'm not a changeling.
You make a good point there. You were taken in by our queen's good graces after your real parents abandoned you, alone in the desert. If it weren't for her, you wouldn't be alive today. But I'm afraid that's not the answer. I'll ask again. Do you know exactly why you don't deserve to be a princess?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Of course you do. Princesses are supposed to be like a replica of their mother. Strong, resourceful, holds a tight grip on her power over the kingdom. You, however, are not. You are weak, small, utterly useless, and a great disappointment. You are nothing like us, regardless of who you are or what you are. Because of all this, because of what you've caused, you know just as well as the rest of us that you don't deserve to live or be loved for the lowly weakling that you are. And that no pony will even remember you after you are gone. You got your water. Now get out of here before I force you out.
Come on, get in there quickly before I push you in. Your meal will arrive momentarily. Try not to soak your rags.
Magna was right. Why was I ever taken in as a princess? Why was I ever born? Nobody wants me after all. Not even my real parents, whoever they are. I know I must be here for a reason, but what?
Yes, I am helpless. I know that I'm not strong. I know that I was unloved from the start, so don't you remind me. I could take it all back and be what you said, but it won't change what I am. Just one love, one song, one heart I have for you only. Why do these words always strike me to the core? I am told every day from my childhood until I have grown old, I'll be alone in the end, though it never hurts to dream. Into my eyes, sparks of hope had been found in this tragic place. In a page, adventure, magic, and new worlds, happy endings abound. Never I'd found far, far away, life's anew. What I'd give to reclaim that joy that I knew lately, but
It must have glowed without me realizing it. Well, it helps light up the room.
Now, I must warn the general.
My queen! My queen let us in.
Nabis? I thought you were on patrol.
I was. But the queen asked me to stand guard. She didn't tell me why, but I was concerned. She has been gasping like this for 10 minutes now.
My queen, Private Gypsum, checked on the bearer. I don't know how, but she saw her chest glowing so brightly it lit up the whole room.
Don't you think I already know that? I've been feeling it since sundown.
Feel what, my queen?
The element's power. It's growing.
Saying it isn't true, my queen.
Oh, I wish it were. The magic I'm sensing is the same aura coming from those elements of harmony. If I wasn't affected by its magic many times in the past, I wouldn't know.
But that's impossible. We kept her away from Equestria, from her element. How could this be true?
I don't know. But now, by some miracle, her magic is growing stronger! We need to do something about this! We cannot let her use that power against us! It would ruin our chance to finally be free from the elements and rule Equestria!
We could have crystallized her from the beginning.
I heard that! And don't ever question my tactics! Do you realize we kept her this long just to make her weak, miserable, and hopeless? If she ever displays any signs of kindness or even comes near that gem, we'll be blasted into oblivion! As long as she doesn't know about it, the longer we'll have the chance.
My queen?
Since we can't conceal the element's power now, how about we just end it?
What?
It seems I had forgotten the laws that our past queens made centuries ago. One that states that we can only perform the death penalty if they are in the age of adulthood. It applies to everyone in the kingdom, including royalty.
You're not suggesting that we kill Nameless?
Why, yes, my dear! When that is done, we can sneak into the princess's castle and steal the element from their sights! And we'll make sure that a chance for a future bearer will never happen again!
That is an excellent plan, my queen. But in what way should we execute her?
I'm glad you brought the subject up, General. Because this is where you three are going to help me. At dawn tomorrow, I need you to take Nameless far away from here. I don't care where you take her, as long as there's no signs of ponies in sight.
Yes, Your Majesty.
And once you get there, you can do whatever you want to kill her. After that's done, we'll start planning to retrieve the element.
But Your Majesty, what if something goes wrong? What if Nameless-
Nothing will go wrong, Nabis, as long as you stick to Her Majesty's orders.
Private Gypsum is right. If anything were to go wrong, then we should prevent it.
And make it so. We can't afford any risk of exposure. You know what the consequences will be.
Yes, my queen. I'm sorry for doubting you.
You may be new to your position like Private Gypsum and your other colleagues, but at least they show determination and respect to their queen and their kingdom. You should do as well. Do you understand? After your mission is done, have your soldier paired with your private. He is in desperate need of improvement.
Yes, Your Highness.
I promise you and the General, when the dawn comes, he will bring the end of the element of kindness, and then we'll have Equestria to ourselves!